On today's Try to Finish Something, let's take a walk down nerd history. The year was 1977, I was 7 or 8 years old, and Star Wars was released. I saw Star Wars in the theaters 30 times. 30. I know that number because my mom has told me that she had to buy tickets for the same movie 30 times. I was invested in the series. And when my wife bought me a 3D printer for my birthday quite a few years back, I knew Stormtrooper armor was something I had to make. But I could barely print that little tugboat that they give you. I knew this was a task that I was not up for. I did get better at using the 3D printer. And when Rogue One came out and I saw the shore troopers, not as much armor, I knew that was a cosplay that I had to tackle. And I will eventually get 501st approval on that and be recognized by the Star Wars community as a stormtrooper. That's gonna happen. But then The Mandalorian came out. He was a ragtag bounty hunter that had armor from all sorts of places, including he had shore trooper armor. And I knew this was a rabbit hole that I was going to have to go down, and I was going to have to make Mandalorian armor, which I did. And I will eventually go for 501st approval on that as well. But much like that first episode of Star Wars where Luke had to infiltrate the stormtroopers by becoming one and dressing up as a stormtrooper in season 2 of The Mandalorian, Din Djarin has to dress up as an ICAT trooper. He puts on the helmet, infiltrates the stormtroopers. You see where this rabbit hole is going, right? So I am going to make the ICAT Tank Trooper, and I'm going to do the helmet on today's Try to Finish Something.
So here are a few scenes from the episode. It has a mottled paint job, it looks like, with browns, greens, and maybe some blacks and some really heavy drips. In one of the nerd groups that I follow, they were talking about how the costume department painted the helmet with very large paint brushes to get that mottled effect. And they were told to use the Disneyland Haunted Mansion sign for inspiration, which is why you see that bluish copper patina effect. I think it looks really cool. This helmet isn't 3D printed. It's an unfinished resin casting, but it still needs a whole lot of sanding. I got this tip from a guy I knew who painted cars. If you primer and then mist it with another color, when you sand it, you can see the parts that are still that mist color, and those are the low points. If something turns the base primer too quickly, then that is too high. When I'm satisfied, I base it with black. This is a great starter helmet for someone wanting to paint a first helmet. The weathering and that modeling hides a lot of imperfections, and you don't have to have a perfect finish like a traditional stormtrooper, but here I am. I've sanded and primered it 4 times. Again, not necessary. I have issues. Use your hand and feel it for smoothness. You'll get a really good touch the more you do this. Now, the olive green. I hoard a lot of strange things, including this packing foam. I'm using it to hold the helmet upside down, going to paint the bottom, then the top. Now to sand the paint off where the connection is for that blast shield. I love this Scotch-Weld 100 epoxy. It dries pretty quick and it's super strong. Now, another coat of olive green base. Then I will mist it with some black and some tan. I'm going to just do the blast shield to start to see if I like the technique. I've never painted a costume with craft paint, so I'm a bit uneasy with the application. Blending colors and adding a lot of water to do washes and keep pulling the paint off to create the layers. Crap. Honestly, I hate it. I'm considering sanding it down and just starting over. I decided to walk away and sleep on it and take a fresh look in the morning. I found this Topps image and watched the episode again. I don't have a semi-gloss on it yet, which will help the look, but if you look at it here in the dark, it looks better. Okay, maybe it's just too light. It needs another layer. I'm going to do some brown, black, and some dark green washes and allow them to set on the helmet for different lengths of time to dry more and less and keep pulling them back off. Also, I'm going to add some of those Haunted Mansion highlights. You know, I think this is going to work. Now, to paint the rest of the helmet the same way. You know, I've said it before, layers and patience is the key, even for me. Okay, here is a photo of my TV screen and my helmet. It still needs that welding shield cut for the visor, but that hasn't arrived yet. You know, I'm calling this paint finished. As always, if you liked the video, please like and subscribe and tell a friend. If you didn't, please keep it to yourself. And we'll see you next time as we try to finish something.